Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1909, Unpivot with Power Query. Oh, here is a classic problem. This has been covered on the podcast a couple times before, but the answer this time is so much easier. I want to create a pivot table from this data, but the problem is that we have one field, quarter, that is a repeating group going across the columns instead of down. What we really need is we need a data set that has four times as many records and an extra column that identifies the quarter. When you try and create a pivot table from this data, it just is going to be ugly. Insert pivot table. Okay, let's put markets down the left-hand side. Want to choose Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and now I want to total those. Well, I have to go create a calculated item or calculated field to do that. It's just so unfriendly to deal with this data. And in the past, we've used this horrific trick from Mike Alexander with the multiple consolidation range pivot table and double-clicking the grand total. Life is so much easier now that we have Power Query. Now, at the end of this video, I'm going to talk about Power Query, but let's assume you know what Power Query is. We come here to the Power Query tab. My data is already in Excel. This is great for pulling data in from other places, but I don't have to do that. It's already here. It's an existing table, so we choose From Table. My table has headers. Click OK. And we go to the Power Query Query Editor. And in the Query Editor, you see that we have tabs across the top for Home, Transform, Add Column, and View. So I'm going to choose the first column that needs to be unpivoted, and then Shift-click on the last column. That selects those four columns out here in Transform. Watch how easy this is. Just choose Unpivot Columns, and bam, they've now taken that data. It's four times as many records as I had before. They gave me a heading here called Attribute. So let's choose that column and then right click and say Rename and call it QTR for quarter. Press Enter. All right, that's good. That's everything we need. Click Home, say Apply and Close, and we go back to Excel where the original data is still there. So here's the data worksheet that I started with, and here is the result. From here, we're good to go. Just do Insert Pivot Table. OK, and now we'll put markets down the left-hand side, quarters across the top, and then value in the values area, and we are good to go. Power Query. Let's talk about Power Query. This is part of the new Power BI tool. So Power Pivot, Power View, Power Map, Power Query, and then the Q&A is this whole new suite of Power BI, and most of that stuff is for Excel 2013. However, this piece, which is an amazing and varied set of data cleansing tools, is free if you have Excel 2010 or Excel 2013. Just go out to the web, search for a download Power Query, and you can download it again if you have 2010 or 2013. I could spend an entire month doing videos showing all the amazing things that we can do with Power Query. But for this one particular problem, where we have to unpivot the data, it is just remarkably easy to go to the Transform tab and use the Unpivot to solve this problem. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast, Mr. Excel. MrExcel.com.